Thank you very much.
Good to see you.
Good morning. My name is Tetsu Nakazawa. I'm the vehicle line manager for the Mazda 5. Today, I'd like to explain where this vehicle fits in the overall marketplace. Who is the buyer for this vehicle? Why they're buying the vehicle? And what we've done to improve it for 12 model year. So I really like to think of this as our hidden gem in our lineup. This really has a lot of surprise and delight. Consumers are surprised because they look at this vehicle and say, wow, I expect this to be a two-row vehicle, yet it's a three-row vehicle. Customers are surprised when they find out that in the second row captain chairs, there's this underseat storage compartment. Customers are surprised when they get behind the wheel and find out, wow, this vehicle is a lot more drivable, agile, maneuverable than they expect in the traditional family hauler. And finally, they're surprised as this package with three rows, all this standard equipment, actually is so affordable, under $20,000. I'll go over the details, but that package wrapped up really makes it an attractive proposition for today and today's market needs as people are being more smarter in their choices buying vehicles. So how do I look at this marketplace? Well, this vehicle does not fit into any traditional segmentation. It really contains the best elements of many segments. So if you look in industry sources, you'll see that this vehicle is categorized differently by the different industry source. For example, Merit's, one of the biggest research firms, categorizes the Mazda 5 as a minivan because of its great seating capacity. Internally, at Mazda, we categorize this vehicle as a C segment because it is compact yet fuel efficient. Now looking at Consumer Reports, they categorize the Mazda 5 as a wagon because of its dynamics, its drivability, and its size. So really, what is the key opportunity here? The opportunity is if you're in the family life stage, this is a life stage vehicle, you have the young children, this is a vehicle that can draw from many different segments and get new customers, and that's what we expect from this vehicle. So next, I want to further refine this to look at specific models that are compared in the marketplace. So this is the cross-shop data. Number one, a third of the customers do not cross-shop any other model. And then the top cross shops are actually small SUVs, the CR-V RAV4. And then the other top cross shop is a minivan, the Honda Odyssey. So again, this is drawing from different segments, customer bases. They're looking at different types of models, and this is the one that fits their needs the best. So if you look at the top vertical axis, this is purchase price. You can see the Mazda 5 is at a certain price and size, again, affordable price point. You move up, you see small SUVs, a little bit bigger in size, a little bit more expensive, and then kind of at the top of the chart, you'll see the Honda Odyssey, very big, very expensive. So that's kind of the lay of the land for this vehicle. So what does that mean for Mazda as a whole? Basically, as mentioned by Jay, it's our fifth best-selling model after our core model lineup. So we have the Mazda 3, the Mazda 6, the CX-7, CX-9. That represents about 9% of our overall sales. And in terms of our business strategy, we're trying to use this model again as that move up. When a customer is a Mazda 3, they have they're a married couple, maybe they have their first child, they're married, they might have their second child, young children. So in that life stage, whatever vehicle, they might have a Mazda 6, they might have a Mazda CX-7, in that life stage, we want to draw them in here and have them purchase this vehicle. Now, in terms of moving up further, yeah, we have the CX-9 to get those larger families. So next, let's take a look at the customer we're drawing. Well, they're basically married. We have an even mix of male and female. They generally have a child under 12, one or two children under 12. They're in their 30s and 40s. They're college educated. And they have an income of a little over $90,000. So they're well educated, they're affluent. So they understand, once they do the research, Mazda customers do a lot of research on the internet. They take test drives. So once they investigate what's available, what's the price point, what equipment we have in here, this is a really great choice for those consumers. So let's specifically look at the why buys. Why are they buying the car today? The number one reason is the versatility and functionality. That, beyond anything else, the sliding doors, the three rows of seats, the captain chairs, the extra storage areas, that's the number one reason they're buying this vehicle. The next top purchase reason is the affordability. Again, we'll go into the price, but under $20,000, you have so much standard equipment. And some standard equipment that you won't even find on much more expensive vehicles. And in line with that, fuel efficiency is another top purchase reason. So affordability, good fuel efficiency, again, it's really right for today's customer needs. Additionally, consumers are buying for quality, dependability, reliability. This is really a price of entry across all segments. I can assure you it has very good quality. And then I'll move up to the other really important purchase reason. I know it says 2% under safety. Safety is very important, but because it is a price of entry, it isn't a high number out there because it's already expected. And this car already has all the standard safety feature you can expect, and I'll go over that. So this is the key why buys, and I'll go over in detail specifically each of these components. So let's start off with number one, the key why buy, versatility and functionality. And it starts off with the sliding doors, again, the captain chairs, the three rows of seats, the multiple storage areas. And that really, again, makes it a package that fits the customer's needs. Okay, starting off with the sliding doors here. Very easy to open, and the key point is ingress, egress. A lot of hinge doors, you're in a parking space, it is hard to get in here, but here you have such a wide opening, and remember, who are we trying to attract? We're attracting customers with the young children, so this is a very attractive vehicle for young children. And one point that I always hear from the owners is, I had a small utility vehicle. I have a very young child in a baby seat. It's actually hard for me to get that baby seat into that row because it's high up and put that child in there. Many parents understand that point. Now with this vehicle, you can see you're at the level of the consumer where even a female customer can just drop the child in their baby seat. And that, when you're busy with a little child, you find out how great a feature that is. So the ingress egress for that child with a baby, but also with a young child under 12, it's easy for them to open this door. It's easy for them to get in and out. So it really makes it a good situation for these customers we're targeting. The other thing is, if a lot of these parking lots, especially in California, there's just tight parking spaces. You're driving in the parking lot at Costco and you're going, wow, can I fit in that space? That guy's really close, tight squeeze. But with the sliding doors, the usability, and as you know, you can walk, you can open it, and you don't have to worry about damaging the vehicle next to you. And especially in where we are in Orange County, oftentimes you're next to a BMW, Mercedes, and you're going, oh, will my child damage the car next to me? But again, sliding doors, usability, ingress, egress for that customer makes it a great feature for this vehicle, and customers love it. So next, let's talk about the second row captain chairs. And there's two real great customer benefits out for the captain chairs. One is the access to the third row. You have easy access through the center seats to get there. And oftentimes we hear from consumers, you know, that vehicle with three row seats is great, but I have to climb to get back there. And many of you experience that. It's just hard to get back to that third row. So with the captain chairs, it makes it very easy to just walk right through and get to that third row seat. And with the Mazda 5, you have two ways. You not only have the center access, but you also have a one-touch access here where you can walk through as well. So there's two ways to get back there, through the center as well as this one-touch access feature. So what else is great about the captain chairs? Well, the great thing is the comfort, because you do have the inboard outboard armrest. And then in addition, you have the reclining function. So it really makes it comfortable. Not quite as comfortable as your chair at home, but it really is a comfortable chair to sit in because of the reclining function and having two armrests, and you can sit back. And personally, I have two young children, a five-year-old, a seven-year-old. And as parents, oftentimes we're on these little bit longer drives, and we you know, you're in a car with a seat back that's straight up and the child's head is falling. They can't sleep very well. Their head just keeps falling. And what we find with this vehicle, what we do is we say, you know, can you just recline that seat, sit back, relax, and they fall asleep. And as a parent, you know, you're busy doing stuff, you're talking to your spouse. It just makes a great drive when your kids are asleep and you can just talk and listen to music. It really, really is a great benefit. So that's what we really enjoy about having these captain chairs in this second row. Okay, we'll move on to the multiple storage areas. There's some seen storage area, but this vehicle has a lot of hidden storage areas. And one of the hidden storage areas is this storage under both of the captain chairs, and you'll have more time to look at it, but underneath both of these seats, we have this hidden storage area. And within this passenger seat, as you can see, we have a little fold-out table. The fold-out table also has storage. It also has cup holders. So both of these have hidden storage. In the very back of the car, you also have, as you can see from the middle photo here, there's additional hidden storage in that rear cargo area. So you also have the seat back pocket. So what do you use this for? Especially for these families, you have little books, you have games, you have your Nintendo DS, you have your toys. So you have space to put these stuff, basically, in this vehicle. And that's a really great feature and what customers appreciate about the vehicle. Okay, next let's talk about the three rows of functionality. And again, you don't expect this size of vehicle to have those three rows, but it does. And what that allows you to do is have maximum passenger capacity with using all three rows, so you have six passenger vehicle, or you can fold flat this captain chair, as you can see in one photo we have here, actually folds flat. So you can fold flat these second row captain chairs, you can fold flat the third row, which is a 50-50 split seat, so you have maximum cargo capacity, really flexible, or you can have a three passenger vehicle, four passenger vehicle, five passenger, six passenger. So it really can be configured to how you want to use it. And that's what our customers do. They do have times when they need more passenger capacity. They do have times when they have more cargo capacity. And that's the flexibility this vehicle offers. And it really makes a great situation for them. And actually, last night I was talking to Will here, and he has a six-month-year-old child. And one thing we find with young children, maybe your child, when he becomes like 4 or 5, they just love getting back to that third row. I don't know what it is about that, but the children say, I want to get back there. Maybe it's they don't want to be near their parents, but they just love being in the third row. So you're almost going to have to buy this vehicle. The other thing is, you know, we have two children. You're only having one child right now, but when you have two children, sometimes the kids fight. They're just like arguing, or that's my toy, this is my toy. But what you do at that point, my wife says, just get one other child back to that third row. So you separate them. So there's a little bit of distance. And that's the other thing about the three rows is you can separate your child. You have one child in the second row, one child in the third row, separates the children. And again, it really allows you to do that in this compact and efficient size vehicle. So again, great versatility, a lot of uses that you see and you don't see in this vehicle. Okay, now let's go over the next really key point is the affordability. You get all this equipment at under $20,000. So what does it offer? It offers, even in the base sport model, all the power equipment that you need, the power windows, power door locks, cruise control, keyless entry. I'll go over the details a little bit more. But it also offers features that you don't expect at this price point. The sport model, you get alloy wheels. And on a CR-V, RAV4, or Odyssey, much more expensive. Do you get alloy wheels on their base car? No, you don't. Also on the base sport model, you get automatic climate control. Do you get automatic climate control on CR-V, RAV4, Odyssey? No, you don't. Actually, if you want to get alloy wheels and climate control on an Odyssey, you're paying $31,000. That's their base vehicle that you can get this on. And this is under $20,000. So you really get a real well-equipped vehicle, even on this base sport model. So that's what makes this, a smart choice for today's consumers, because they are more careful with how they're spending money. And they say, before, again, we knew that bigger was better. It used to be, you know, we just need that big car for whatever reason. But again, today's consumer is really looking at how they're spending. Do they really need that huge Odyssey in the room? Because that Odyssey is just hard to move around into those tight parking spaces, etc. So really, this is a great vehicle for those consumers. Okay, and this is MSRP chart, again, of what the lay of the land kind of looks like. The manual, which is a 6-speed MT, under $20,000, but even maxed out with the Grand Touring. The Grand Touring comes with great features like rain-sensing wipers, comes with xenons. So that is under $24,000. So you look at a RAV4, again, that car doesn't have alloy wheels. That car doesn't have auto AC. So the price points are, you know, mid-20s. And then when you move to Odyssey, you know, you can get a $40,000 Odyssey or Sienna. So a really different category price point, and it has all this other expense that really you don't need. Again, sliding doors, yeah, we could have put a power sliding door in there, but in terms of complexity, in terms of adding weight, in terms of adding cost, those things don't quite make sense for the consumer that's really saying, hey, you know, the door opening works. It works for myself. It works for my small children. So you don't need to add those expensive features that you aren't going to use. I mean, you know, in your computer, you use Microsoft Excel. How many features don't you use on those, on the, you know, computer equipment? It's the same thing. We're not going to add it unnecessarily more expense, more weight, more complexity, just for the sake of having it. So that's how we're moving forward in our marketplace. Okay, let's look at standard safety. Again, consumers really, really value safety. They want to protect their family. So this vehicle has all the standard safety features: ABS, traction control, dynamic stability control, tire pressure monitoring system. We have the different front, side curtain, three-row airbags, the smart accelerator pedal, the triple H body structure that you're all familiar with for Mazda Unique, you know, to keep safety really a strong structure. And we have our engineer who will go more in detail about that. So standard safety, again, from the sport grade all the way grand touring, you all get these features in every single model. Okay, let's talk a little bit about dynamics. And that's what Mazda is all about. Mazda has their unique driving DNA. You know, we want to really, even in a family vehicle, we want to incorporate it where a customer from the sports car to the family vehicle to notice that driving dynamics. They can drive and feel, wow, this is agile, this is maneuverable, and definitely this is something that consumers really find appealing about this vehicle. So again, it's a really agile, maneuverable, and what we've done for 12 model year, we've upgraded the performance. We went from the 2.3 to the 2.5. We have more horsepower, we have more torque, but we even improved the fuel economy, 1 mpg on the highway for the 5AT. So we've done a lot on the dynamics. And also on a base sport, we've gone from a 5-speed manual to a 6-speed manual. So for those drivers, you can still get a manual transmission. Now in the industry, it's almost hard to find a manual transmission. But again, for that unique consumer that really wants to drive themselves, you can get a 6MT on the Mazda 5. Next, I want to talk about design. And again, this is the first embodiment of the Nagari design. And you're asking yourself maybe, you know, what were we thinking? What were we trying to accomplish with this vehicle? Well, the first thing is, consumers don't want to be labeled as a soccer mom. You've heard that term many times, and even people who are attracted to this vehicle go, you know, it kind of is too family-like for us. So what we decided to do was, let's try to stretch the design envelope with this vehicle, and we use the Nagari design element to bring that to market. So we wanted to bring a little bit more emotion. We wanted to bring something that was unique. So we took that Nagari design language and brought it to market, and that's why we did this, because we didn't want to keep it that traditional family hauler look. We wanted to bring some expression, emotion into the marketplace. And again, this is something we don't think Honda, Toyota, Nissan would try to challenge into the marketplace. And that's why we brought this to market. And we have Ken Sayward back here. He'll go more into the details of what we tried to accomplish and why we did this. Okay, so overall, what's new? Again, new exterior design, new interior design. We added upgraded engine with more horsepower, more torque, better fuel economy. We added the 6MT, we've added other standard equipment I'll go over shortly. And then this is the model lineup. We have the sport grade, basically comes in either a 5AT or 6MT, and you get all the standard equipment you need. You have standard power windows, power door locks, cruise control. You get the redundant audio and cruise on the steering wheel. You get the you get the captain chairs, you get the 50-50 split third row seats, you get the hidden storage compartment, you get the storage under the second row seats. And again, you get the features like the alloy wheels, the automatic climate control. That's all standard in the sport grade. So really, even if you get the $20,000 model, you're getting a fully equipped vehicle. Now, when you move up to the Touring, what do you get? Touring model, you get a lot of external differentiation. You get the side steel spoiler, rear spoiler. You get fog lamps on the interior. Oh, also, you'll go from the 16-inch alloy to the 17-inch alloy. You'll get the leather-wrapped steering wheel, leather-wrapped shift knob. And then the big thing for this year is we're moving the Bluetooth hands-free phone. Again, ever more popular. We used to only have that in the Grand Touring. We're bringing it down to the Touring model. And also, we've added Bluetooth audio as well. So that's the big key feature we're bringing down to Touring. But the audio portion is new. And then new for 12 model year is the trip computer as well. So that's all standard. And then finally, I want to move up to the Grand Touring. The key feature is the leather seats with their heated seats as well. But also, you get a lot of other good equipment. You get the power moonroof. You get the things that are not really common yet is the rain-sensing wipers. You'll get the Xenons, six-disc changer. You get the Sirius with 4 months subscription. So you get all that equipment, again, under $24,000, a really good value. And again, I don't like to use this term too much, but the smart choice for today's consumer. So that's the lineup. We just have a couple packages, really simple. You can get a moonroof audio package on the Touring grade, has a moonroof, the six-disc CD changer Sirius, and the only other option is the crystal white paint. So finally, for myself, to wrap up, I know design will go over this. Sport and Touring models, they have cloth in black or sand. Grand Touring, you get black or sand leather. And then we have six exterior colors. These are the new colors for 12 model year, the Clearwater Blue, and also we have the Metro Gray. Really looks sharp on these cars.